What did you learn when flipping your first investment property? That is today's question. Hey everyone, I'm Eren Millam with Premier Property Group. I help people achieve financial freedom and security through real estate. This is a fantastic question, and there's a couple things that I learned. The first thing that I learned is, especially in this market, you have to get creative with how you structure the deal. Some deals are not going to be able to work if you do the regular purchase and sale or buy a home outright. Sometimes you have to get a little fancy. So for example, I offered on mine, because it is such a limited profit range, and I knew I was going to be putting some repairs into it, what I offered was a small purchase price, and then we would split the profits after I've recovered all my expenses from the rehab. So what I needed at the time was a risk-free strategy for purchasing the home, and this worked for the seller. So if we did an outright purchase, I probably would not have been able to offer him as much because I'd be taking on a much greater risk, if that makes sense. So I'm offering him a low amount, and then he's going to recover part of the profits at the end. That would be more than I could offer him just to own it outright and have all the risk on me. So that's the number one lesson that I learned. The number two lesson I learned is I am more capable than I thought to do these repairs. And the number three lesson is I never want to do repairs. Again, I didn't even do that much, but it is such a time suck that it is much better to be done, at least for me, to have professionals do the work. Now, I did get some bids for work that I didn't really think were necessary or were overblown, so I did some of that work for myself. But some contractor came in and wanted to redo a large portion of the insulation under the home. When I got under there and did the work, it was actually probably at least a tenth of what they said was needed to be done. So that was a like $3,500 fee, which, you know, if they had bid me like $1,000, I probably just would have had them do it. But they so overdid it that I had to do that work. Anyways, just kind of blabbering. The fourth lesson I learned is you're going to be tempted to take shortcuts. And as someone who hadn't done flips before, I never understood the shoddy work I see from a lot of the flippers that are out there. Now I get it. It's just a lot of work to take on yourself, but it's really important that you take the time to do it right. Just because as someone's walking through the house and they see something wrong, then they see something wrong, then they see something wrong, it just paints a really bad picture. So you want to make sure you do things right. And if you're not capable, then you need to get a contractor in there to take care of the work for you. The fifth lesson I think we're on now is a lot of these projects that I think, man, I can knock this out in like an hour, no problem. Sometimes they turn into a day or more. They really take a lot more time than you think, just because things don't work exactly how you want. Once you really get into stuff, you realize it's not as cut and dried, so simple of an issue. So make sure that you are planning for more time if you're doing that work yourself. And the sixth lesson I learned is it's actually really hard to make decisions. So when you're flipping a home, you know, what style do you want? What color do you want? What finish do you want? For example, just getting the paint, there's like five different, you want a white paint, okay? There's 30 different white paints. Okay, so now you gotta settle on one white paint. Then from there, is it interior or exterior? Then from there, is it soft, flat, whatever, etc. There's like six different choices. So for something as simple as I want white paint, now you have another five decisions associated with that. How much do you need? All these sorts of different things. Oh, here's some more supplies you're gonna need when these are painting. So the decision fatigue when you've never done this can be overwhelming. The more you do it, the more you're probably gonna use the same materials. I see that a lot from flippers. I totally get that because there's a lot of decisions out there that are really unnecessary. Like, okay, I'm a guy. I want white paint. I don't want to make decisions beyond that. I want white paint. But the world we live in, you know, there's 10,000 different white paints. So decision fatigue is a real thing, and I was not aware that was going to be an issue. The other thing is when you are trying to make a decision, but you're waiting on a decision from over here that you have to make, but you can't see it without this decision being made, that can literally explode your brain. So if you are getting interested in investing, that is something to be aware of and ready for. Make sure you have a solid plan going in. Do not forget. That will make your life so much harder. So if you're looking for more advice or have any questions about my experiences, I'd be happy to take some time and sit down with you and go through them. And tell you what I've learned. Again, my name is Eren Millam with Premier Property Group. And remember, never settle for less than extraordinary.